Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and this video is actually going to be a tips and tricks video, a video that I type of video that I haven't done for a very long time. Normally my older videos recently have been rants and ramblings, cartel pack openings, those kinds of videos, but I want to try to make a turn back to doing some tips and tricks, and there is quite an interesting one here for you guys. So this one is going to be a credit making tip regarding converting your command tokens to credits. And the reason I think this is quite important is because for any of you who do endgame gearing, you usually have an excess of command tokens because you earn more command tokens than you need to spend on gear. Usually the limiting currency are the unassembled components that you get from doing PvP and ops, and so normally you have enough command tokens. As you guys can see, I have like 1,000+ stored up here, and if you go to this vendor here, the intended thing that Bioware kind of expects you to do is buy command boosts with them. However, there is another crafting material that was added here recently. This one is really cheap. It only costs you 3,500 raw credits and 6 command tokens. You can buy one of them. You can buy as many, obviously. And you can sell that straight back to the vendor for 25,000 credits. But obviously, you're not going to want to do that. You're going to want to run over to the GTN and sell it there. And what you'll see later on in this video is it's selling for quite a lot. So at the time I shot this video, I put mine up on the GTN for 170,000 credits. I bought up 20 of them, first of all. I put them all up on the GTN for 170,000 credits, and about 10 of them sold at that price. So that's 1.7 million credits right there. But actually, as you'll see in this video, the price dropped because this was back right when it was released. So obviously the GTN is going to fluctuate a little bit in price. If we look at it right now, at the time I was making this video, it costs around 90,000 credits for one crafting material. I did end up putting the rest. I'll show you guys the video of me collecting the successful item sales, and the other 10 did end up selling for 90,000 credits. So that's right there, 900,000 more credits on top of that. So I made almost 3 million credits, and all I bought up were 20 of these crafting materials. In total, that cost me 120 command tokens and about 75,000 raw credits, because keep in mind you do have to pay 3,500 credits for each of them, but that's not a big deal, it's a really small price. So as you guys can see, these are the ones that sold for 170,000 each. I sold them in stacks of 2, and then I'll skip to another clip where I sold the rest of them for 90,000 credits each. So they do indeed sell really well at these prices, and at this point in time the price was fluctuating a little bit because the market was still kind of getting ready for this new crafting material. But I can confirm for you that as of right now on the Harbinger server, these do sell in the range of 100,000 to 130,000 credits. Recently, I have not seen this crafting material, and I've been monitoring it for about a week. It has not dropped below 100,000 credits so far. Maybe after I put this video up, it might drop a little bit lower because people are going to watch this video and then go buy it and put it up on the GTN. But do expect the prices to stabilize around that price range of 100 to 120,000 credits, because that's what I've seen it drop to recently. So it is indeed a very, very excellent conversion of command tokens to credits. I do believe it's one of the only conversions of command tokens to credits available right now. And it's really quite good. I mean, think about it. You can convert 120 command tokens to like 3 million credits. That's really crazy, considering people who do a lot of endgame stuff like PvP, PvE, flashpoints operations, they usually have a ton of these stacked up. And you can now go ahead and convert them to tons of credits. And definitely take advantage of this while the price of these crafting materials is still pretty high. Also, take a look at the command boosts themselves. Like the superior command boost that you see here, you can buy it for 190 command tokens and 50,000 raw credits. Right away, that is super expensive, considering you could convert 120 command tokens to 3 million. And also, the price of these superior command boosts on the GTN is only 2 million credits. So you kind of, if you didn't know about this, you'd be wasting quite a lot of command tokens and potential credits buying the command boost from this vendor. Also, keep in mind, if you buy it from this vendor, the boost only lasts for 2 hours. If you buy the GTN version, which has got off the cartel market, that one will actually last 3 hours. So it's a lot better to go to that vendor, buy the crafting materials, sell those crafting materials on the GTN, and then use those credits to buy the superior command boost off the GTN. That way you get a boost that lasts for 1 more hour, and it costs you less credits. You'll also have a few, a million or so credits left over to just go ahead and do whatever you want with. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found this tip helpful. I definitely have been using it to convert some command tokens to credits, because I have a lot of them left over. And yeah, maybe get to grinding some of those that endgame gear and those command crates, because you can make quite a few credits off of this. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. I'll see you guys in the next one.